Good day, everyone. Today, we will be discussing about non-current assets held for sale and discontinued operations. This is under Chapter 4 of Intermediate Accounting Part 3 and under the standards of PFRS 5. Pagpapain muna natin kung ano ba yung non-current asset. Non-current asset, alam na natin to since senior high school, naririnig na natin to. It is a residual definition of a non-current asset. Ibig sabihin, kapag hindi nag-fall sa criteria ng pagiging current asset, mag-fall siya under non-current asset. Ano-ano ba yung mga examples ng non-current asset? Yung mga buildings, yung lands, and also yung mga disposal groups. Maraming examples ng non-current assets. Pero under PFRS 5 or under this standard, ang itatake lang is yung PPE, property, plant, and equipment such as buildings and lands. Pangalawa is yung investment property measured at cost model. Pangatlo is yung investment or yung long-term investment such as investment in associate, investment in subsidiary, or investment in joint venture. Pangapat is yung mga intangibles such as patents, copyrights, and trademarks. Disposal group is defined as a group of assets to be disposed of together as a group in a single transaction and liabilities directly associated with those assets that will be transferred in the transaction. Nabanggit ko na ito kanina na yung disposal group is also a non-current asset. It is a cluster of assets na i-dispose by selling, pero kapag binenta mo siya, dapat in a single transaction. And hindi lang yung asset yung itatransfer. Dapat pati yung liabilities na directly associated with those assets will be transferred also in that transaction. So, na-define natin kanina kung ano yung non-current asset. Ngayon, i-define naman natin kung ano yung non-current asset held for sale. Pwede yung maging disposal group asset held for sale. Yung non-current asset, pwede yung maging disposal group asset held for sale. And paano po masabi na kapag na yung isang asset is held for sale? Kapag ka yung carrying amount niya can be principally recovered or principally settled through selling. So, ano nangyari kapag ka yung non-current asset is transferred as non-current asset held for sale? Nahihinto na yung pag-recover mo ng depreciation. So, yung depreciation, hindi ka na magre-record niyan. And yung non-current asset mo, yung non-current asset na meron ka, will become a current asset since held for sale na siya and hindi ka na nag-depreciate. So, ito yung mga conditions para maklasify na yung isang non-current asset yung isang disposal group is held for sale. Una na dyan is yung non-current asset or yung disposal group is available for immediate sale and is present. Ibig sabihin, yung non-current or yung disposal group is available for immediate sale. Or, pwede mo na siyang ibenta as is. Anong ibig sabihin nun? Ibig sabihin, yung non-current asset or yung disposal group can be sold as seed. Ibig sabihin, wala ka nang ibebenta, ay wala ka nang aayusin, wala ka nang i-repair. Pangalawa is yung the sale is highly probable. Kailan ba natin nasabi na yung sale is highly probable? Kapag ka, etong tatlo, etong lima. Una is yung entity's management is committed on selling the asset. Ibig sabihin, merong plan. Merong plan na yung management. Hindi bara-bara or hindi ora-orada na kapag ka naisipan ng management na ibenta yung asset, ipapabenta na nila. Ibig sabihin, they are committed to a plan. Pangalawa, the entity is actively locating a buyer. Since they are committed to a plan, they must be taking an action para maibenta talaga yung asset na yun. Or they are currently locating a buyer. Naghahanap sila ng pagbibentahan. Pangatlo is yung selling price or yung sale price is reasonably in relation sa current fair value. Example, kung 1 million yan, kung 1 million yung current fair value ng non-current asset mo, held for sale, hindi dapat sobrang baba at hindi rin sobrang taas sa 1 million. Kasi pagka sobrang baba na ng selling price mo, dun sa may, or sobrang layo na dun, nung selling price mo, dun sa may current fair market value niya, ng asset mo, ang nangyayari is naging donation na siya, lalo na kung sobrang baba. For example, 1 million, tapos binibenta mo lang siya ng 50,000 or 20,000, parang dinodonate mo na lang siya. Pang-apat is, the sale is expected to be completed within 1 year from the date of classification. Kapag kaganyan, hindi naman lahat ng oras nasusunod yan, or there are exceptions. Sa next slide, makikita natin kung ano ba yung mga exceptions. Kasi hindi naman porket dinuso ng management na mabenta siya within this year, mabenta agad yan. Panglima is, it is unlikely that the plan to sell will be withdrawn. It is unlikely that the plan to sell will be withdrawn. Ibig sabihin, yung commitment ng entity's management sa plan na ibenta yung asset is hindi agad-agad mababago or hindi magkakaroon ng subsequent changes. For example, ngayon, naisipan na nung committed na yung management sa isang plan na ibenta yung asset. Tapos, hindi pwedeng after a month, i-revert it back. Kailangan, it is unlikely na magkakaroon ng changes. So, nabanggit ko na ito kanina na there are exceptions sa 1 year requirement. Kasi hindi naman lahat ng oras mabibenta agad yung non-current asset mo, mabibenta agad within 1 year. So, there are exceptions. Una na dyan is, there must be a delay. Merong delay na beyond entity's control. And pangalawa is, merong sufficient evidence na yung entity or the management remains committed on selling the asset. Paano mo masabi kapag pagka yung management remains committed in selling the asset? For example, merong asset na binibenta na ang fair value is 150,000 and prenesyuhan ng company ng year 1 ng 120,000. So, after 1 year, hindi siya nabenta. So, ang tendency, ang ginawa ng company, binabaan nila yung presyo. Kasi bumaba rin yung fair value ng asset. Kasi yung fair value ng asset naging 125,000 na lang. Tapos, ginawa ng company, ang naging selling price nila ng year 2 is naging 100,000. So, it is a sufficient evidence kasi yung management nag-take ng necessary actions para mabenta yung non-current asset held for sale nila. So, next, property dividends. Yung property dividends, maklasified lang siya as held for distribution to owners. Kapagka una, it is available for immediate distribution and kapagka it is highly probable na i-distribute na sa owner. Pangalawa, the non-current asset that are to be abandoned. At yung mga non-current assets na hindi mo ibebenta, kumbaga tatapusin mo yung economic useful life niya. And these non-current assets that are temporarily taken out of use are not treated as if they have been abandoned. Yung mga assets na hindi mo ginagamit ngayon, it does not necessarily mean na they are non-current assets abandoned. So, yung non-current asset held for sale is initially and subsequently measured whichever is lower between the carrying amount and the fair market value less cost to sell. Paano ba kinukuha yung carrying amount? Yung carrying amount, kinukuha mo siya through historical cost less yung mga accumulated depreciation. Depreciation and amortization, interest and other related expenses attributable to financial instruments included in a disposing group are continued to be recognized. So let's have this illustration. On December 31, 20X1, Tres Marias Collection classified its building with a historical cost of 2 million and accumulated depreciation of 1.2 million as held for sale. All of the criteria under PFRS 5 are complied with. on that date, the land has a fair value of 780,000 and a cost to sell of 30,000. So, una muna, kung natin yung initial measurement. Paano mo kukuha yung initial measurement? Sabi natin, whichever is lower between the carrying amount and the fair value. So, ang carrying amount niya is, makukuha mo siya through historical cost less yung accumulated depreciation, yung 2 million less 1.2 million. So, meron pang carrying amount yung building na 800,000. And, yung fair value less cost to sell is 780,000 less cost to sell na 30,000, which is 750,000. So, ibig sabihin, yung non-current asset held for sale mo is i-measured mo siya at 750,000. So, paano siya i-record? Ganito siya. Building held for sale is 750,000 kasi whichever is lower nga daw between carrying amount and the fair value less cost to sell. And i-record mo yung accumulated depreciation 1.2. Then, kung ano yung then magkakaroon ka ng impairment loss na 50,000 kasi ito yung kulang. Ito yung, dahil 2 million yung historical cost mo, yung talagang cost ng building. And 1.2 plus 750,000, 1.2 million plus 750,000 will be 1,950,000 lang. So meron kang 50,000 na i-recognize as impairment loss. So you will record a building of 2 million. So next, the building was not sold in 20X2. However, the exception to the 1-year requirement was met. On December 31, 20X2, the fair value less cost to sell of the building is 725,000. So, paano mangyari dyan? May carrying fair value less cost to sell is 750 minus 25,000. You will recognize an impairment loss of 25,000. Bakit? Saan mo nakuha yung 750 na to? Yung 750 na yan, nakuha mo siya dun sa may fair value sa nakaraang year, ng 20X1. And yung 725, ito yung fair value less cost to sell in year. So, pag pinag-minus mo sila, ang makukuha mo is yung impairment loss na 25,000 and maalok, and ililess mo siya sa main building plan for sale. So, yung disposal group na define na natin siya kanina. Disposal group is remeasured in accordance with applicable PFRS. Nire-remeasured muna siya based dun sa may applicable PFRS bago dun sa may ginagawa nating fair market value less cost to sell of the disposal group of remeasured. So let's move on to the second part of our discussion. The second part of our discussion is about the discontinued operations. Discontinued operations, it is defined as a component of an entity that either has been disposed or is classified as held for sale. And it represents a separate major line of business or geographical area for operations. For example, ano ba yung major line of business? For example, yung SM. Sa SM, ang major line of business nila is yung supermarket, yung department store, and yung mga leasing activities na ginagawa nila. Pangalawa is, it is a part of a single coordinated plan to dispose of a major line of business or geographical area of operation. Ibig sabihin, hindi lang isahan. Ibig sabihin, it is part of a plan. Pangatlo, it is a subsidiary acquired exclusively with a view to resale. Hindi mo siya in-acquire para gamitin. In-acquire mo siya para ibenta. And next, we already stated that it is a component of an entity. Pag sinabi natin component of an entity, it may be a subsidiary. It may be a subsidiary. It may be a major line of business. Pangatlo, it may be a geographical segment whose operations is yung cash flow can be clearly distinguished from the rest of the entity. Paano bang masasabi na yung cash flow is can be clearly distinguished kapag yung assets, liability, revenue, and equity are directly attributable to the component. So when to classify component as a discontinued operation? Una na dyan is when the entity has actually disposed the operation. Kapag yung entity disposed the operation, it would be considered as a discontinued operation. Pangalawa is when the operation meets the criteria to be held as held for sale. Ano ba yung mga criteria to be held as held for sale? Nabanggit na natin ito kanina dun sa main non-current asset for sale, yung mga criteria niyon. Una na dyan is yung it must be available for immediate sale at its present condition, or the asset must be sold as is. And pangalawa is yung the asset must be highly probable to be sold, or the sale is highly probable. Presentation of discontinued operation. Sa income statement presentation, or the statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income, discontinued operation must be disclosed using a single amount, which is called the income or loss from discontinued operation plus the post-tax profit or loss, post-tax gain or loss on measurement of fair value less cost to sell. So presentation in the statement of financial position or in the balance sheet presentation. Sa asset, ipapresent mo siya as non-current asset held for sale, which is considered as a current asset. And pangalawa is, it is a assets and liabilities of a disposal group are presented separately, which is the liab is presented as a current liab, of course. So that's it for this video. Thank you and God bless.